I'm Dr. Nan again. Last week I had posted my own recipe. Today I'm going to post a very interesting recipe. I have already given my introduction. I actually did my MBBS from NIS Medical College, Kolkata, and then I did my postgraduate in London. However, I'm going to do the Kashmiri Rogan Josh. The Rogan Josh has two varieties basically. One variety is the Kashmiri Hindu Brahmin Pandit, and one variety is Kashmiri Muslim society has Rogan Josh. Actually, when I was in England in 1990, it was painful to see the Kashmiri Brahmin Pandit had a genocide in their own places. It was 1990. So today I am going to do the cooking, which is actually done by usually Kashmiri Brahmin Pandit, and I will dedicate it for them. The difference between the Muslim Rogan Josh and the Kashmiri Pandit Hindu Pandit Rogan Josh is that the Muslim society uses piyaz, onion, adrak and rasam, but in Kashmiri Hindu Pandit they never use this one. Then actually it was used to say that is Rogan Josh is vegetarian, actually not vegetarian, but they don't use none of this. Thing I am going to use, this is my meat. You have to make it very large cut, and better if you have the posterior part of posterior legs run and the back, but I didn't get it. Somehow I managed to have this ribs mainly, like a chop cut, and I use salt, definitely some salt. This is adrak dust, ginger dust. This is mori dust. These are the all masalas. This is Kashmiri lal mirch. I didn't use because in Kashmir Pandit, because the Kashmiri lal mirch is only happening in Kashmir, so they don't use actually except Kashmiri lal mirch. They don't use other mirch. This is it. As they don't use any type of adrak, rasun or onion. So they use hing. There's quite a lot of hing. This is about full 2.5-3 teaspoon. The amount of mutton I'm saying about 1.2 kgs. This is soap powder. This is Kashmiri lal mirch and hing. And the masala I'm using, the whole masala is some long and chote elaichi, and for the color I will use, this is called rogue ratanju. I will show you how to extract the color of the ratanju. This is the dahi I will use, about 400 gram of roundabout. I didn't measure it. It's about 400 gram of dahi. It's homemade dahi, and I made it. For the water, I actually had some mutton broth in my fridge left. You can use always water, plain water. The Kashmiri use mainly plain water, but I will use this one. Not much. I will tell you how much. Okay. Now I am starting. I'm starting heating the pan. Actually, in Kashmir, they don't use this type of vessels. They use clay pot. I have a clay pot, but it is too small. That is why I didn't use it. I use this one. You just heat it up. Then go. You'll be surprised. It is used to no ghee, only sauce, mustard oil. Possible. Now I'm pouring the mustard oil, about 5 to 6 tablespoonful, because the mutton is about 1.52 kgs.
The whole masala is chota elaichi, about 2 bara elaichi and long. You don't use any other whole masala like cardamom or anything. The oil is quite hot now. I put this one in the. Now I put the meat straight away. Meat is not. Meat doesn't have any salt or anything. Just you have to fry it. While I am doing the frying, I put the all the masalas here, the gas masala. Here the red chili powder, the Kashmiri red chili in my yogurt. Here the hing, everything. This is the sauce, ginger, dust, soap ka dust, all go. You have to mix it very well. No other masala is good. Now you can see the mutton is almost fried. I have actually fried it. I put some salt on it according to your taste. The mutton is well fried. So all the flavors of the whole masala I have used is gone inside it. I have cooked this mutton about maybe 15. I am frying this mutton for 15 minutes. That's 15 minutes. Now I shall add this meat. I boil the mixture of dohi and other masala. Toba, should I get to it? I am mixing this with the mutton very well. Then again, I have to saute it for another 5 to 10 minutes. You have to mix it very well. Keep your flame lower side because otherwise the dohi may get wobbly. First, you mix it properly, then I will put it in high. I will give the dohi with, I put it some chicken broth and water, just little bit water with water, and put it here. I leave this to cook for a quite long time because unless the when the oil will come up, I will show you again. Now you can see the oil is separating. So I put the broth now. Another thing I want to tell that everybody has a belief that the Kashmir has the Mughal influence in their cooking. The Kashmir Brahman Pandit is older than Mughal Empire. Shahjahan went there, actually Shahjahan, Mughal got lots of things from Kashmir. No, Kashmiri Pandit didn't take anything from Mughal, but Shahjahan took this way of cooking and make it in their own way cuisine. The called Rogan Josh. But if you really want to do the Kashmiri Rogan Josh, which was very old, and it has the influence of Persian actually, mainly Persian. It comes through Silk Route. Kashmiri cooking has the influence from the Silk Route rather than Mughal. And it has lots of influence from Persian, Turkey, Turkestan, Kazakhstan, those places. Now I will add the water, and the water is
should not be much. You don't
Use any tomato or anything for coloring, because I will show you how to color this one. And don't give too much of what I'm just giving, just to keep it down. That should be enough. And what I do, I will now taste the salt. Once it started boiling, I'll put it in very low flame, and at last I will show you how you make the Rogan Josh red, really red. No food color is added. I would suggest a little bit water, because it will evaporate a little bit. So I am using mutton broth, but if you don't have, just put some hot water. Don't give too much water. That's it. That's more than sufficient. Once it boiled up, I will come back about 45 minutes. I will put it in the very slow flame. Put it in the oven as well. It's very low, about 180 degrees. You can put it in the oven so it can cook from the all the sides. Okay, it started boiling now. Put it in the low flame. So if you want to really cook the Kashmiri way, don't put any other masala which I have mentioned, because it doesn't mix the original Kashmiri Rogan Josh. I can see it started boiling. Okay. Alright. Problem with this, okay, started boiling, I will cover it. Put it in very slow pan. Now I switch off this one and just see, yes, it is boiling. And just switch off it and put it in slow pan. And I will back in 45 minutes. Now you can see the liquid has been reduced. We should not have more than this. Actually, in Kashmir, there is less liquid. I never use tomato to give the color. Now I am going to tell you how I color this one. This is Rotonjo. This is absolutely safe. It's the bark of tree. I will give you how can you get the right color. You have to put some ghee. How is the make it well. How do I give it a bit? This is the only time you add the ghee here. Now I put some Rotonjo. This here is the Rotonjo. Look at the color. I'm going to add this one. The color has come out properly. Don't use any water or anything, just use oil or ghee. Ghee is the better one. You can see the color is coming up. Now I actually put it on my
float it in the slow heat for another 10 minutes. So the color will come out. I will show you after 10 minutes how the color is.
This is my final Ratan Josh. Now I am just switch off this gas and check whether the mutton has rise. I am sure because the total cooking time was half an hour and then 45 minutes, about 1 hour 50 minutes. I hope the mutton will be soft. Anyway, my daughter will check this one. Look at the color. This is Ratan Josh. Now you can garnish, that is my version. You can garnish with dhaniya, fresh coriander. But actually in Kashmir, this has been cooked and well cooked. Okay, now try this one.
I will show you, try this one.
Look at the color. Oh wow!
It's hot. It's very. Let me try this one. Let me try. No, 12 minutes.
You loved it.
Lovely.
Delicious.
Yes. Now it is done. Look at the meat. Look at the meat. Look at this. Mutton has been done. Wow!
It's delicious!
I can't tell you. I can't show you. So, last of all, I want to finish this one. One thing, this is the during the corona epidemic, I am a doctor, as a doctor, I have to give some advice. Follow the whatever advice the government of India has given, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has given. Wear the mask when you go outside. Wash, if you are inside your home, please wash the hand every half an hour with soap or sanitize with alcohol-based sanitizer. And please keep the distance. Please keep the distance when you are giving a queue or in anywhere you are standing in a queue. So I would advise to use an umbrella. So automatic distancing will be there. Never do the handshake. So namaste. I this is the second post I am doing. Whatever you like, you can choose from this one. This two. Okay. Thank you.